Welcome to the Bureau's long-range forecast for February to April 2023. Wetter than normal conditions are likely to continue in much of the north and parts of the east coast, but drier in the southwest. First, let's look at recent conditions during January. Widespread rainfall and severe storms affected most of northern Australia in early January. A number of areas have also been drier than usual this month, including southeast Queensland, western Tasmania, and parts of the Top End. Ex-tropical cyclone Ellie brought intense rainfall, leading to significant flooding in Western Australia and the Northern Territory in early January. Heavy rainfall mid-month also led to flooding in North Queensland and the Central Coast between Townsville and Rockhampton. More than 1 metre of rain fell in 1 week in sites around Mackay. Floodwaters in the Murray and Darling Rivers continue to impact parts of Western New South Wales and South Australia. Large areas across the north had cooler than average temperatures because of the thick cloud cover. Some sites in Queensland had their coldest January days on record, while parts of the south and central regions had heatwaves with unusually hot weather for 3 or more days in a row. High rainfall has kept soils wetter than usual across much of the north, while parts of the west and east are currently drier than average. Water storages overall are 8% higher than at this time last year. Many are more than 100% full. Exceptions are Tasmania, where storages are down to around 54%, and the southwest coast of Western Australia, which is around 57%. So what's likely to influence our climate over the coming months? La Niña is easing in the tropical Pacific Ocean and is likely to end in February. Even as La Niña weakens, it will continue to influence our weather and climate for some months. This includes increasing the likelihood of tropical cyclones in our region. Severe storms and active monsoon bursts do occur at this time of year, so please be prepared. The long-range forecast for February to April shows above average rainfall is likely for parts of the east. It is the wet season, so northern Australia typically has high rainfall this time of year. It's likely to be drier than usual for southern parts of Western Australia and South Australia in coming months. Higher than usual stream flows are forecast to continue for much of the north and east. With more rain likely in areas of wet soils, high river flows and full dams, the risk of flooding remains. The outlook is for warmer than usual days for most areas, particularly for the southwest, the far north and southern areas including Tasmania. Nights are also likely to be warmer than usual across most areas. Parts of the south have already had heat waves during January, and there's an increased risk of more to come. Hot nights during heat waves make it harder to recover from the heat of the day, and this puts more stress on the body. Bushfires are always a risk in summer. Heatwave conditions add to the fire danger, and fire agencies are closely monitoring areas of above normal bushfire risk. Recent wet conditions have led to abundant vegetation growth, and that can also increase the risk of grass fires. So in summary, from February to April, we're likely to see above average rainfall for parts of the east, but drier in the south and west, continued flood risk in some parts, warmer days and nights for many areas, above normal bushfire potential for some areas, and an increased chance of tropical cyclones. You can find the latest long-range forecasts and warnings on the Bureau's website. Bye for now.